I set my own timer. First, hi everyone. Thank you for being here tonight. I'm going to talk very fast about the Holy Grail layout, which in the mind of the all marketing people is the ideal layout for a web page, because it would allow you to have a header, a footer, a column for menu content, and a column for advertising. People try to do that for a very long time, and there are many, many, many ways in which to do it. None of them ideal. That's why the crusade is still going on. Here we have a breakup of the Holy Grail layout and the conditions for a layout to be called holy. It has to have a fluid center and fixed size. All columns have the same height. And nice to have is to have the footer stick at the bottom, content being first in the code order, and as the markup being as clean as possible. First, like all the web, it started, you can do it with the frames and frame sets. It's very difficult to actually find today a server, unless you really run it yourself, where you could go with the frames and frame set. But that's the code for the Holy Grail layout, run and made with frames. The main problems with frames were like, before the very hard to index, very hard to bookmark, accessibility, and all the new doc types got rid of them, so no. Next, tables. Everyone, I guess, remembers how it was to build a very complex layout with tables, how intricate it was. We have the same code here for the Holy Grail layout with the tables having header, columns, content, and footer. Almost the same problems as with the frames, just not that much. Next, there was a very smart guy called David Sennerholms, who came with the idea of using a background on the image on the background that will make it look like there are actual columns. And this is how the Holy Grail layout will look with this technique. There is a link below to a code pen with the actual code for it. Main problem is you have to have the layout fixed, because the image on the background, you can't stretch it. So no full page websites if really needed. The next option would be to use JavaScript to read the size and set the height equal for all of them. Again, code link for the code pen below. I'm not going to run the test right now because I will be running out of time. So, but if you go there, that's a screenshot. Click on toggle equal columns and you will see everything stretching up and down. Next is an emulation of the frame set only done with absolute position. That's the closest you could get with modern techniques to emulate a frame set. You still have everything on the screen, the scrolling content. It just won't scroll outside the viewport. With the CSS3, you can play very nice things with display table, which allow you to mark the divs as to behave like the cells of a table. So, again, link below for a Holy Grail layout made with CSS display table. Next, and I guess the most flexible technique to do it today is Flexbox, in which you control the flow of the elements. The main advantage here compared to the previous ones, you can tell the content to be first in the code order, but place it second using CSS. There are a few other approaches, some working better, some working only with experimental features. Like we can use bottom padding and negative margin to push everything down and then up again, which will equalize the columns. The problem with that is if your page is actually higher than those 34,000 pixels that modern browsers support, you'll be back to square one. You can have nested divisions where with the shift of relative and absolute positioning, you're putting three containers with three different background colors. You're shifting them side by side, so you have blue, shift white, shift red, and then move the columns, shift it in the opposite direction to to take the same the second to last would be okay. I'm out of time. So very fast, we have the more experimental techniques with grid layout and template, which are you can get them working in a few special situations. And the quest continues.